Welcome back to BOGO Biology. In this video, we'll be discussing the classic Hershey and Chase experiment and how it proved conclusively that DNA was the molecule of heredity in 1952. Remember that there are four major groups of biomolecules: carbohydrates, lipids, proteins, and nucleic acids. In the first half of the 20th century, scientists still weren't entirely in agreement about which biomolecule passed genetic information from parent to offspring. Many believed it to be proteins because they're so large, structurally complex, and have so much variety. Dr. Alfred Hershey and Dr. Martha Chase's now famous experiment was actually the third investigation into what genes are made of. They learned from the previous work of Frederick Griffith in 1928, and Oswald Avery, Colin, MacLeod, and Maclyn, McCarty in 1944. It's important to know how each experiment built upon those that came before in order to understand the experimental design. First, Frederick Griffith proved that some sort of substance could be transferred between bacteria, which could change its properties, in a process we now call bacterial transformation. He called this mysterious substance the transformation principle and demonstrated its power in a famous experiment involving mice and pneumococcus bacteria. Harmless R-strain bacteria could still acquire material from a dangerous S-strain bacteria and become deadly. However, at the time, Griffith didn't know exactly what type of molecule the transformation principle was. Second, Avery, McLeod, and McCarty performed a series of experiments to isolate the transformation principle and analyzed it extensively. They found that the mysterious substance was most chemically similar to DNA. Then they methodically destroyed proteins, RNA, and DNA, and discovered that disabling DNA prevents bacterial transformation from occurring. However, the scientific community disputed Avery's results at the time because they believed that trace amounts of transformation principle could have contaminated their samples of DNA and that proteins could still be the molecule of heredity. If you'd like more details about Griffith's or Avery's experiments, I've left links to tutorials on them in the video description, as well as links to some guided notes for each video. Hershey and Chase picked up where Avery and his colleagues left off and set out to prove once and for all whether the molecule of heredity was protein or DNA. They chose to do their work by harnessing a simple virus called a T2 bacteriophage. These bacteriophages have several helpful properties, including the fact that they reproduce very quickly and are only made up of two of the big four biomolecules, proteins and nucleic acids. Hershey and Chase had previously studied the properties of these bacteriophages and had concluded that the protein formed a type of protective coating or shell around the nucleic acids. Bacteriophages naturally reproduce by attaching to the outside of a host cell. Then they inject their genetic material into the host. It hijacks the internal workings of the cell, and the empty protein coat stays on the outside. The empty shell is sometimes also called a protein ghost. The DNA from the bacteriophage then causes the cell to stop whatever it was doing and begin producing identical copies of the original bacteriophage. The host cell then explodes, releasing all of the new bacteriophages, which then go out and infect even more cells. Hershey and Chase harnessed this viral life cycle to prove which of the two contenders was actually responsible for inheritance, proteins or nucleic acids. Hershey and Chase used two groups of bacteriophages and made a single component radioactive in each one in order to keep track of what it was doing. In one group, they tested the viral protein coat on the outside, and in the other group, they tested the nucleic acids on the inside. They knew that whichever part was responsible for genetic inheritance would create more radioactive bacteriophages and the other would not. Proteins and nucleic acids contain some of the same elements, including carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, and nitrogen. They differ in that proteins can contain sulfur and nucleic acids contain phosphorus. The researchers tracked the elements that were unique to each biomolecule. In proteins, they replaced the sulfur with a radioactive isotope known as sulfur-35. Since sulfur is not found in nucleic acids, but is found in some amino acids in proteins, they were only marking the protein coat. In the nucleic acids, they replaced the naturally occurring phosphorus with a radioactive type of phosphorus called phosphorus-32. Since there was no phosphorus found in the protein coat, the only thing they were marking in the second group was the nucleic acids. Once the appropriate molecules were tagged, the experiment consisted of three major steps: infection, blending, and centrifugation. In the infection step, Hershey and Chase allowed each type of bacteriophage to infect a host cell to see whether the radioactive proteins or the radioactive nucleic acids would make radioactive bacteriophages. Next, in the blending step, they used a high-speed blender to jiggle the E. coli cells enough to shake off the empty protein coats on the outside. This step is why this experiment is sometimes affectionately referred to as the blender experiment. This created a mixture of liquid, phage parts, and bacteria called a suspension. Finally, in the centrifugation step, they spun this mixture in a centrifuge so that the heavier bacteria condensed and formed a pellet at the bottom of the tube. Since the virus particles were much smaller and lighter, they remained suspended in the liquid, otherwise known as the supernatant. Hershey and Chase measured the level of radioactivity in the liquid and in the pellets to see where the radioactivity had ended up. The researchers knew that the virus had transferred its genetic material, whatever it was, into the bacterial cells. Because the bacterial cells were heavier, they would end up in the pellet along with the injected radioactive material after centrifugation. If proteins were the molecule of inheritance, the pellet would be more radioactive than the supernatant in the protein group. If the nucleic acids were the molecule of inheritance, the pellet would be more radioactive than the supernatant in the nucleic acid group. When they tested the two groups, they found that the supernatant was more radioactive in the protein group, and the pellet was more radioactive in the nucleic acid group, indicating that viral DNA had entered the cell. This provided very compelling evidence that nucleic acids and not proteins were the molecule of inheritance. Because the experiment was conducted using bacteriophages, some scientists were still skeptical of its implications. Some believed that, while Hershey and Chase had proved that DNA was the genetic material for viruses, it might not be the genetic material for more complex organisms. Dr. Alfred Hershey would eventually receive the 1969 Nobel Prize in Medicine for this work. However, it's worth noting that the Nobel Committee, frustratingly, excluded Dr. Martha Chase, and Alfred Hershey did not acknowledge Chase's role in discovering that DNA is the molecule of heredity when he accepted the prize. That wraps up our discussion of the Hershey and Chase experiment. If you found this video useful, please consider giving it a like or a comment and subscribing to the channel. Thanks again for watching. See you later.